This is the draw for the sixth round proper of the FA Challenge Cup.
Number 5.
Bristol City or Cambridge United?
Number 1.
Against Crystal Palace.
Is the thought of Wembley now sort of beginning to slip into your mind?
Yeah, because like Andy Fawn, who had the same similar kind of run for Wimbledon, he tells you what it was like.
Having done it for Wimbledon, no doubt you want to go out and do it again.
Well, I hope so. I mean, it went so quick last time, it'd be nice to go back.
Have some of the players been to you and said, well, what's it going to be like? Tell us some of the experiences.
They keep giving me stick because I keep telling them what it was like.
Manager Steve Coppell, of course, has also seen it all before.
Some will say 1st Division against 4th Division, you should win fairly comfortably.
Yeah, we won't be saying that. We know. We've seen Cambridge a number of times this year. We know they're a good side. They've got a lot of young, hungry players who are desperate to do well. The implications are obvious to everyone concerned, although we're certainly not taking anything for granted.
And he's got help here. And Wright's there, so is Chappell. This is Thomas. And Gray! The flag stayed down, and Andy Gray volleyed wide. Now, this is Ian Wright, and Andy Gray's right in the middle, and Pardew's making good ground as well. That's Wright's cross. Pardew! Oh, well hooked out by Liam Daish. And Gray! Pardew looked to have the first opportunity. Who'll start the second half on the offensive. Thorn is facing the kicker, O'Reilly's up just behind him. And Pardew comes in with the goalkeeper, that's Andy Thorn. Chappell away, Thomas. Still not clear, Wright with a chance for Palace. Saved by the goalkeeper's legs, and Bailey clears. And Ian Wright has the best chance of the match, and John Vaughan thwarts him. That was O'Reilly. Pardew comes in and Chappell clears it for a corner. They've defended well, the First Division team, and now they're on the attack with Gray about to take the corner. O'Reilly! And Barber. Thomas! It's gone in! Jeff Thomas has scored for Crystal Palace! Number 8, and they're in front in the last quarter of an hour. 78 minutes, and the 4th Division side are caught out from the corner kick, and Jeff Thomas, 25 years old, the captain, the man who turned the Portsmouth tie in the third round, may have turned this one. It's Gary O'Reilly, really, who causes confusion. Barber tries to hook a shot in and fails. It comes back out to Thomas, and it's through the legs of Chappell. How unlucky. And the goalkeeper never saw it. It's Cambridge United 0, Crystal Palace 1. And Palace have got an eye on the semi-final. Chappell having to hurry, though, to try and cut off Wright, and this could end it. Wright's away, and he's got Gray in a great position square. And Ian Wright and Andy Gray, did he handle it? The linesman says yes. The referee hasn't seen it. It's still Gray. And there's number 2, is it, by Sulaco? But no, surely there was a handball. I wouldn't think that goal would stand. Sulaco put the ball in the net. Kieran Barrett, the referee, then saw the linesman's flag. Now, that was for hands against Andy Gray when the ball first came in, if you watch this. Ian Wright is clear. Goalkeeper goes to meet him. Now, watch number 4, Gray. That's a handball. John Sulaco. Thomas, the goal scorer. And Crystal Palace are through to the semi-finals of the FA Cup. Cambridge United of the 4th Division see the Twin Towers of Wembley fade and can't quite make history. A really good cup tie, must be said. The crowd appreciated it. It was very well contested and in the best possible spirit. And the disappointed 4th Division players are consoled as they leave the field, but they leave their name on the FA Cup in 1990. As for Palace, thanks to Jeff Thomas, they're still on the road to Wembley.
Well, Jeff, what's the Palace reaction in the dressing room after that victory?
Obviously, very happy about the result and everything. We knew before we came here it was going to be such a hard battle, but We got the goal that counted.
Well, you got the goal that counted. One of your better ones, or a hint of good fortune about it?
A lot of good fortune, I think. A very rare one to get with the right foot. Scuffed it in, really.
I think it went through the defender's legs?
It did. Big centre-half, he just got his legs twisted up a little. Just went through his legs and sighted the goalkeeper.